Top 10 African countries that want to move to the US. Welcome to my channel, The Kenyan American Home. And if this is your first time, welcome. Feel free to hit the subscribe button and become part of the Kenyan American Home family. And yeah, welcome back to my members, my subscribers. Thank you so much for the love and support that you always show me. So today we're going to look at the list of 10 African countries that really want to move to the US. So we're gonna rank them from number 10 all the way to number one. So how did I come up with this number? Every single year there's a DV lottery that takes place, and the DV lottery is free to apply. And so I've used this numbers because it's, you know, it's free to apply the DV lottery. And so what better way than to see the number of people who, you know, freely apply for the DV lottery to come to the US. So I've used the numbers of all the people who've applied for the DV lotteries. And so the data for the the latest few years, 2023, 2024, 2022, are not available yet. So the data that I've used are from 2019 all the way to 2021. And then, so what I did is 2021, there was COVID, and the numbers were skewed in looking at the other numbers. So I removed 2021 just to, you know, make sure that all the years were normal. So these are the top 10 African countries that want to move to the US based on either the number of people that applied, and I've used an average of the number of years that I have here. So to start off the list, I'm going to do some honorable mentions. Honorable mentions is Morocco. Morocco, there was an average, you know, between 2019, 2020, there was an average of 230,000 people that applied for, you know, the DV. So that's a huge number. I mean, that's a huge number. Algeria comes in as another honorable mention. There were 290,000 Algerians that applied for the DV lottery between 2019 and 2020. And then let's get on to the list of the top 10 African countries that, you know, want to really move to the US. So coming in at number 10 is the country of Sudan. Sudan in East Africa, there was an average of 300,000 people who applied for the DV lottery. 300,000 people. Sudan comes in at number 10. And then number 9, all the way to, we go to West Africa. Number 9 is the country of Cameroon. Cameroon comes in at number 9 with an average of 310,000 people who applied for the DV lottery between 2019 and 2020. And then coming in at number 8 is my country Kenya. Kenya comes in at number 8 with an average of 360,000 people who applied for the DV lottery in between 2019 and 2020. And then number 7 is the country of Liberia. So Liberia comes in at number 7 with an average of 450,000 people, you know, like an average of 450,000 people average every year that have, you know, applied to come to the US. That's 2019 and 2020. And then number 6 is the country of Egypt. So Egypt, I have to mention Egypt here because when it comes to DV lottery and actually being allocated number of selected participants, Egypt is usually one of the top 2-3 countries. They usually have the most number of people selected in the DV lottery. And so Egypt comes in at number 6 with an average of 530,000 Egyptians that applied for the DV lottery. 530,000 Egyptians. And then coming in at number 5 is the country of Congo Kinshasa, with an average of 770,000 Congolese that applied for the DV lottery between, you know, 2019 and 2020. And then coming in at number 4 is the country of Ethiopia, East Africa. So Ethiopia, East Africa, with an average of 780,000 Ethiopians that applied for the DV lottery between 2019 and 2020. That's a lot. That's a lot of people. It's a lot of people. And then coming in at number three is the country of Sierra Leone. Sierra Leone, with an average of 980,000 people that applied for the DV lottery, applied to come to the U.S. Close to a million, 980,000 Sierra Leoneans. And then coming in at number two, which is like, number two is like, wow. So there's Sierra Leone at number three with 980,000. And then number two is the country of Ghana. And Ghana is, it stands above its own. Like there's no other country that is even closer when you look at all the other countries. Ghana comes in at number two, West Africa, Ghana, with a whopping 2 million people on average that applied for the DV lottery between 2019 and 2020. 2 million. 2 million people. Wow. 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 That's a lot of people. That's a lot of people that want to move to the U.S. and leave their country. Leave their country. And drum rolls. Coming in at number one is none other than, hey, you guys guess. You guys guess which country is this one? Which country in the whole of Africa? Eh? Which country in the whole of Africa wants to come to the U.S. so much above everybody else? Drum rolls. Number one is the country of Nigeria. Woo! The country of Nigeria, West Africa, comes in at number one. They want to come to the U.S. so much so that they've even been disqualified from the DV lottery. Why? Because there's been so many people from Nigeria who've immigrated to the U.S. Nigeria stands. They are the only African country that has been disqualified from the DV lottery. The only African country that has been disqualified. Because they have like, it's like we, too many, we just too many Nigerians. And so, there you have it. That's the list of the top 10 African countries that want to really move to the U.S. And it's not a bad thing. I totally do understand, you know. Coming from Kenya, I moved to the U.S., you know. Life is hard back home, and a lot of it, you know, we talk about leadership and all that stuff, but, you know, it just, corruption and all that, but it all starts with us, you know, it starts with us. I'm hoping the future holds better for Africa. There's, you know, Africa is talented, resourceful, it just, we have everything in Africa, but it just, for some reason, we haven't just gotten it together. That's why you have so many people cramming to, you know, coming to leave the African borders and go look for better elsewhere. It's not like, you know, some of us, it's not like we didn't try. We did try, but it's hard. It's hard when you keep trying and there's no opportunity, no hope, man. But this is, you know, cheers to a better Africa. And cheers to a time when we'll all want to stay back in our home countries and not move to make our lives better or, you know, survive, end poverty and all those so many things. But thank you so much for joining me. Man, if you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. So what I do is I give information about immigration, legal ways to immigrate to the U.S. So, you know, we talk about visit visas, we talk about work visas, you know, we talk about student visas, a lot of visas that some people don't talk about, you know, student visas, not just F1 visas, but also J1 visas and M1 visas, you know, M1 visas for vocational. But we also talk about work visas, like the J1 visa is also, you know, there's a lot of, J1 visa has like 14 different programs in itself. And J1 visa is mostly predominantly work visa, temporary work visa. These, you know, work visas like H-1B visas. and you know, H1B, a lot of Africa, like pretty much all the, all the African countries qualify for the H1B visa. It's just that a lot of African countries don't qualify for the H2A, H2B visa, which is kind of unfortunate, because those, you know, seasonal jobs are really, that would be really good for, you know, good opportunities for Africa. But a lot of the African countries have been disqualified, you know, from, they're not on the list for that. But there's so many visas that we tackle, you know, religious visas, you name it, P visas, O visas, Q visas, R visas, it's like U visas, T visas, because that's kind of how they name the visas. They start from A visa to B visa. There's a C visa, C1D, C1, C1D, D. There's an E visa, there's an F1 visa, there's a G visa, there's a H, which is a lot of the work visas and all that. So yeah, that's what we do here, educate you on the so many different ways that you can come to the U.S. There's over 100 different types of visas that can bring you to the U.S. But unfortunately too, a lot of people don't know about that. A lot of people just stick to, you know, the student visas, the visit visas, because that's all we know. That's all we know. So I'm here to educate you and give you other ways that you can come here legally. All right. Well, thank you so much. And hope you guys have a good rest of your day. Peace.